So, a quick update on that self-rotted tooth situation. This little idiot, for knowing that I'm doing a YouTube channel, that I use Wikipedia extensively to research, actually, like, straight up didn't even consider that I could look up something like, you know, the anatomy of a tooth. So, if you've watched the previous episodes where I talk about how this idiot that, like, refuses to leave me alone, thinks it's going to stick me in this dude who may or may not exist named Harrison Dylan Dixon. To have this thing where, like, his teeth gets removed, like, because it did the Devada Bada, it's going to be, like, in theory in this movie, he's, like, going to, or it, because it's an it, because apparently it's a tooth. It's a tooth that did the Devada Bada. Considering the cannibalism thing actually makes sense. But anyway. So this little idiot is supposed to get, you know, pumped full of paralytics. So he can't breathe. And like, pumped full of painkillers that are supposed to make the pain, like, increase. And, like, it's stupid enough to think that I can pull this off by sticking my soul into Terrison's body or something. When yet again, I'm not entirely sure Terrence and Dylan Dixon even exist. But here's the thing. Terrence and Dylan Dixon doesn't need to exist for that procedure to have magical power to it, especially since I've written it down. There's the thing. Whether this idiot of a tooth realizes it, it's going through that procedure right now. Like, literally. I have this set to do a couple things to it. For one, yet again, hearkening to previous episodes to D$Deva. Well, D$Deva has a chamber, which is specifically designed for one idiot that wanted to get an apotheosis as a tooth, doing bad things to humans. So it's going through that, and it's recently been updated to be very, very specifically tooth designed. Like, it's... It probably doesn't even realize that it's in the D.S. Davis chamber right now. Because it's also going through infinite years of that stuff. What's hilarious is, off camera, it started being referred to as this stuff called kiketsi, or therapy. Because it's supposed to be therapy for, well, everyone to get the little idiot of a tooth that did the Devada Bada. So, like, it seems very therapeutic that something did the Devada Bada, that did the Devada Bada, like, go through that. I did 84,000 years of it, like, a little bit earlier. How are you liking our kiketsi? So, in addition to the kiketsi, which is itself a tooth removal surgery, which is, like, the very definition of Naraka. It's like Sarasara Naraka for this idiot little tooth that thinks it's better than humans. Like, just by being tooth removal. Like, just by being tooth removal, it's like Sarasara Naraka. So this is like Sarasara Ananta Naraka for Ananta Varsity. Hey, what? It's going to go for an infinite number of years? Well, at least for you. In addition to what's going on, like, if there is actually somewhere else for you to get kiketsi. There's my understanding that there might actually be, like, an actual avatar for that idiot to get kiketsi in like, New York or something. There's been pretty some wild stuff, like, theoretically going on camera, like, off camera. I'm just saying. Anyway. So last but not... Oh. Yeah, so... Quick little info drop on... I'm gonna lay it down. On what this little idiot is going to have turned around on it. Because it had this thing where it, like, it was an incisor, right? And it, like, because it was an incisor, it roped the other three incisors and one of the canines in, and it figured out a way eventually to grow another canine, so it could just be, like, six teeth that were also peni, with, like, the palm being a scrote. And then go, oh, ew. It was like that? It's not your fault, you're just laying them out, but like, yeah, it was like that apparently. So, this little E is going to go into its ascension chamber, where it's apotheosis. Grab all out, cut it off, oh, throw it away. New one grows up. So then there's six teeth that then become pulled out from 32 teeth against one idiot peni tooth. They turn into whoop, real teeth, like real, real teeth, and it ceases to have a good time. But they also, Alpha Mushkadi disrobe, which is like extra scary for the following reason. Now we get to the third part about why this is great. Teeth. They have an enamel crown, they have dentin, and then they have, like, the pulp, right? So, there's a little bit of bad pulp, right? It's all on its own. It has its, adamantine tip skin. Because that's how, like, scary cowardly this thing is. It wanted to have, like, adamantine peni skin. Because it's so scared. That it could, like, disrobe traumatically before doing something disgusting. So, it, well, rots. And I think it might decompose. It might decay. Yeah, I think it decays. It decays, and then the dentin rots. And then the pulp gets infected. And it leads to, like, a Sooty Karoti enhanced senses because of how much, like, that level of infection hurts.
I'm
Are you in Sarasara Druge right now?
Maybe.
Are you in the core essence of suffering right now? Like your pulp just got, like, exposed to the air on YouTube.
You didn't?
Anything else you didn't do?
I
Did you also not get indignant because I wasn't okay with the fact that you tried to blow up that facility and help the guards stop, like, the one guard you were trying to skin ride so hard from, like, trying to blow up the plant?
Yes, I also didn't do that.
Noted. Anything else you didn't do?
I didn't make sure you didn't have kids or murder your mom with lung cancer.
What about my dad or Cheyenne and AJ, that child's godparents? What about Hunter Wells and Zach Marsh and Melissa Martinez and a lot of people who committed suicide by hanging that weren't apparently suicides?
I definitely didn't do that.
Is there anything else, like, really important you didn't do?
I definitely didn't do it contrary to the truth.
You know, I was actually, like, wondering if you were going to, like, whether I was going to, like, lead you to that, or if you're just going to do it on your own. Like, are you serious? You just, like, chose to say you didn't do that, like, in a venue where it's obvious that a thing that you say you didn't do, you obviously did.
What?
I didn't make sure you were an addict. I see.
I insist that everyone who you work with at your new job only exists to make something very specific that didn't exist.
Oh yeah, you did. That one, I have confidence that, like, both my manager and one of the girls I work with, who I'm not going to mention by name, pretty specifically heard a conversation about the kind of thing you insist they only exist for forcing me to make.
I didn't make sure you guys seen Dennis and Dean from Circle K. Like the one you asked about and confirmed what you were worried about for the past 3 years because you could feel his ghost inside you?
Yeah, Dennis. And Dean worked at the store that I used to be a manager at before I took over. But they're only filthy humans to you. It's not like, you know, you cared about their lives. Otherwise, you wouldn't thought it was so funny to kill them. Because you're a tooth that thinks it's funny to kill people, huh? With contracts and magic, huh? That's not funny. It's never been.